welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Lee Sin Zed. We're going to be playing this with Freljord instead of Targon. I know that Lee Sin Zed, that combination is the most popular with Targon, but I've always really liked it with Freljord. And we got a donation deck to try it again here with Freljord. Lots of donation decks again today to get to. So this is a fun one to play. Basically, the reason why to play Lee Sin and Zed with Freljord is because Freljord has some really awesome protection spells. And to be able to get through and be able to protect your Zed. You have Troll Chant and Elixir of Iron. Both of those are very, very efficient cards at protecting Zed. Plus, you have some Frostbite. We're going to be playing two Brittle Steels, one Flash Freeze, and one Harsh Wind. So some good Frostbite to be able to keep Zed alive if they block and end up making their thing larger. But then the other thing that Freljord gives you, since we're playing a lot of spells, because of course Lee Sin, we want to play all these spells, is we have a way to buff up our champions with Starlet Seer. Starlet Seer is going to be a big part of our deck, trying to get this on turn two, cast our spells, grant the top ally of our deck +1/+1, which hopefully those allies are going to be our Zed and our Lee Sin, and be able to buff them up with that. So we've played this deck a couple of times before, but we've made a few changes since the last time. Really what I wanted, basically we had Omenhawk in here before, Omenhawk being really important at blocking against like your discard burn. But now with like other aggro decks being fearsome, Omenhawk's a little bit worse, and a lot of times we would have like get all of our +1/+1s and then we draw the Omenhawk that's like a 4/4 or a 5/5. And that's kind of a feels bad. We want the +1/+1s on these other things. So what I'm going to try instead is playing Feyguide. Now, I know it's not going to be the turn one blocker, but the Feyguide being able to grant an ally elusive is just always awesome with Zed. Or if we end up buffing up something else with Starlet Seer, right? If we have like a couple Starlet Seers out and then we buff up, you know, an Avarozen Sentry and make this thing like a 10-9. Like that can happen. And then we can Feyguide it and give something elusive. Also, we're going to try a couple of other top-end cards because we can't always find Zed and Lee Sin. So I think we need a couple of more top-end cards. We're going to play a Field of Rush in here to be able to find Zed and Lee Sin and put them up to 10-10s. That's pretty awesome. And I kind of wanted to try a Howling Abyss because this card is just a whole lot of fun to play where you create the random level 2 champions in hand. That's always a lot of fun to play. We'll see. Maybe this should just be two Field of Rush. You know, Field of Rush, of course, is amazing, but I just want to play a Howling Abyss because that card is a lot of fun. So I did have two entreats in here before, so that was where we found room for one of those. We took out one entreat for one of those, and then the three Omenhawks turned into two Feyguides and the other one. And then I kind of moved some spells around. Deny is really important these days. I added a third Deny, added a second Spirit's Refuge since we don't have the Omenhawk to block, since I felt like Lifesteal would be really important. So I added a second Spirit's Refuge and trimmed the second Fury of the North. We had those two numbers switched before. And then I had three Brittle Steels before and no Flash Freeze, but I wanted to have one Flash Freeze over the third Brittle Steel. So that's where we found some other numbers. And we used to play a Stand United. We had one Stand United in here because I always liked that spell, but that's where I got the third Deny instead of that card. All right, so let's give this a try. We're going to go play our five games over in Ranked. All right, so we're going to be playing Go Hard to start with. I'm looking at the Fury of the North, but I don't know, maybe I shouldn't. Ooh, I like that Grant Zed Elusive. That's pretty good. Definitely love Nopify. Nopify is a card that you need to be able to counter a Go Hard. Prediction thing.
I'll burn for all I've done. Let's get to it.
So we're in kind of a difficult spot where I want to play Starlet Seer into Zed into Feyguide, but then I also want to have Nopify available, so it's... I guess I just take a turn off. I think that's probably the most important, because I don't want to play Starlet Seer right now and then they play Go Hard on my Starlet Seer.
Do ya?
We see through all. These eyes see all.
I Apeshies. Fly away while you can!
I don't really need to entreat. Alright, counter that. So that's one go hard out of their deck now, so they only have two more. So there's only two more in the deck. One mana short from being able to play Zed and have deny available. Looks like I'm probably playing entreat this turn.
Keep up, keep up.
Just gotta counter the go-hards.
This will be a good winter.
Okay. Alright, so they only have one more go-hard in their deck. If we can find the other counter spell for it, we could take all of them out of their deck. That would be amazing. But we're going to have to draw one of our counter spells before they draw one of those. We have five counter spells in the deck. Two Nopify, three Deny.
This'll send them running.
This will be a good winter.
Down to 10. Good Glimpse Beyond. Hopefully they don't find the third go hard. Hopefully they don't draw it. Maybe it's down at the bottom of the deck. I hope so. Huh.
They won't suffer long. We go as one.
It's kind of weird that they just took Powder Keg whenever I'd be able to open attack.
Clear off.
They're playing Withering Wheel. I guess that's why.
An auspicious season.
I am the shadow.
Withering Whale is not cool.
I'm always up for a round or two.
Blessed by snow and stars.
I'm a people person.
Back to our perch.
Only I can endure the dragon's fury.
So we're at 6 out of 8 for spells for Lee Sin.
There's plenty of killing left.
I'm at 8 life, which is not very many. Not very much.
Yippee! I talk to spirits! These are my rules!
Okay, let's see.
The dragon waits.
So casting, you know, the two parts of the Sonic Wave and Resonating Strike would level up Lee Sin. Probably can't go to one, can I? Probably can't.
I am a true master.
That's why this Go Hard deck's so good, even though we've been like shutting them down for the most part, to just have so many units that are so cheap that pressure our life total so much. Oh well. That's really good. So let's see. I guess I'm just going to go Sonic Wave and Spirit's Refuge. But then if they have a Glimpse Beyond though.
Two.
I want to play this Abyss and just get this Abyss in play.
I'll see this through.
Go!
will not hold back.
I'm gonna do this. I really hope they don't have. Really hope they don't have Glimpse Beyond. They've already played one.
My land, center your spirit.
This is gonna be, you know, I'm just basically doing this to heal my Nexus 14. No. I guess, you know, Vengeance obviously kills me too. So, like, yeah, Vengeance or Glimpse Beyond. Either of those, but hopefully neither. I'm hoping that's just, like, a Vile Feast or something. Yay! Okay. We're still in it. Back up to 18.
Like a fish in water.
That's probably their go hard. Create this Howling Abyss.
I've whipped up something special.
So I can play this and keep the Lee Sin alive, or I can just wait and cast a new Lee Sin. I just cast a new Lee Sin. Get all its health back instead of being at 2. Well, Hecarim's pretty crazy, so it'll bring 2 5-2s in attacking. Let's see. No, I'll just attack like this.
You got legs. Use them.
Looks like more Withering Whales.
You can't do this.
Alright, so this would put Hecarim down to 1. Alright, so I could Fury the Spectral Rider to kill their Sprayfin. Man, these Sprayfins. I want to grant the Hecarim Elusive so I can block. And then Fury it next turn. But the problem, if that one card is something that does 1 damage, also I guess I'm in a lot of trouble because then I don't have the Elusive anymore. But I think I need to play the Fey Guide so I get another blocker.
Keep your head down, okay?
You have a blocker for the deckhand, a blocker here. Alright, cool. That was not a go hard. In hand, ooh. Sejuani's cool. And that Troll Chant works really well. I can do the plus and then also minus the other Sprayfin. Well, we're getting good champions with the Howling Abyss. This is gonna be close. The Dreadway? Whoa. Okay, maybe not so close.
Beware the dragon spirit.
So now these are both 4/2s. Effectively.
Got a surprise for him.
Strike.
I guess I just take 4. And do this.
Over here.
A in the mind.
All right, down to five. All right, really hope to draw a spell to turn on Lee Sin's Challenger. Kinda.
You own what you take.
Can't deny that. You're nopify, not deny. I guess I should have just open attacked. I don't know.
We still survive.
We're playing against Trundle Trinomir. So yeah, those of y'all here on Twitch, if you want to wager channel points on if I'm going to win or lose, you can do that. Flash Freeze is awesome after, you know, after they play like that top end card, but I don't know if I want to just keep it in the opener. I guess I probably do. We probably need it. I don't know. That's tough. I'm definitely keeping. I guess we don't, because we have to deny for that top end card. Feel the Rush. That's the name of it.
Who goes there? These eyes see all.
All right, well, not the best of hands for me right now with all spells to go along with the Starless here.
Gotcha.
Literally all spells. How many spells in a row is this? I only kept deny with Starless here. That's seven spells in hand plus the one we just cast, so eight spells in a row. Wow, that's crazy. I think this is a good matchup. I've usually done good in this matchup of, like, you know, you play a Zed, because Zed kills them, like, Zed and Lee Sin both kill them, like, pretty quickly, and you protect them and that kind of stuff. You have, you know, I can, like, their big things, I can bounce their big things, or flash freeze them, or Lee Sin challenge them. But if you don't have anything except for spells. Alright, so if I play this, we're gonna have 4, 8, we'd have 10 cards in hand, so we just run out of cards. Alright, let's just bounce this.
This would be a good winter.
Definitely considering just playing Elixir of Iron to make it two spells, so the Deep Meditation. I guess I'd only save one mana on Deep Meditation, that's probably not worth using. Come on, Nopify. It is probably the worst card to see, Nopify, that is.
Blessed by snow and star.
It can't be.
In Avarosa's name. This would be a good winter.
Okay, are we gonna get something? Okay, cool, Lee Sin.
Only I can endure the dragon's fury.
Alright, that will give Lee Sin Challenger, but not Barrier. So I could challenge like the three, I could just kill the 3-1. And turn Lee Sin into a 7-6. Or kill the 5-5. And then Lee Sin's a 7-4.
Strike firm. Center your spirit.
I think that's worth. Cheers.
conflict is all in the mind.
Blessed by snow and stars.
Okay, so we're at 6 right now. Zero mana. That's fair, he said sarcastically.
Conflict is all in the mind. My lands need prepare yourself.
Okay, one field to rush down. No, another Lee Sin. It's also really big.
Their heartbeats quicken. Conflict is all in the mind. I will not hold back.
Blessed by snow and stars.
Just gonna do this. Okay. I'll keep their thing alive at 1.
They walked around.
That's fine.
King of trolls coming through.
Fae-guide. Well, Fae-guide on Lee Sin doesn't matter as much if I'm going to be doing challenger type stuff. So I could Fae-guide the Starless here.
Stay hidden.
I don't know if I love this.
You're in my kingdom now.
So basically what I'm concerned about is I don't really want to just play this like Sonic Wave. I don't think. I guess I am at 8. Maybe I need to.
Conflict is all in the mind. Strike firm. Prepare yourself.
So I'm basically kind of thinking that like the elusive with the, I mean I could give the 2/2 elusive, but you know it's a 2/2. But elusive with the Lee Sin means I could, you know, be attacking their Nexus and not have to spend spells to challenge and things like that. This allows them to generate another ice pillar.
Ice to meet you.
I hope Nopify does something.
I'm gonna make a U-sickle.
Unclear if it will do something, but I hope it does. Down to 3. Now Zed's a card I would have rather gave elusive to. That's a good elusive card.
Deny me.
Conflict is is all in the mind.
I have many faces.
So that I can counter. Harsh winds I couldn't deal with. No. Okay, I can nopify that one. Alright, so I nopify that, and then where are they at? They're going down to two. Okay. Surprised they didn't just throw an Avros and Sentry in front of one of these things, though. I was worried about having Zed do that because of Frostbite card, but I guess if they have a Frostbite card, I'm probably dead anyway. Maybe I should have Zed challenge. Please don't have another big thing.
These are trolls.
No. Man, I should have killed the ice pillar.
I'll knock him dead. Smashing. This is gonna be fun.
Should have killed the ice pillar. Let's see. Yeah, it's lethal. Man, both of these games were so, so close, and we just ended up losing. And I bet I could have won both of those games. They were just so close. I'm sure I could have. It's a really difficult games to play. This is a difficult deck that we're playing here. Alright, prediction started. And they got Zed in their Yasuo Aurelion Soul deck. Okay, I guess we'll keep Avros and Sentry.
Who goes there?
Love double Starlet Seer.
My faith protects me.
Triple Starlet Seer.
I am the blade.
Wow.
In the darkness.
Devotion through battle.
This would be a good winter.
I'm at 14.
The order.
All right, cool. I don't want them to know about 5-4 Zed whenever they are playing their card and making their decision for what they're getting with the priestess and everything. Yeah, we lost Gucci. Very good, interesting, close games, but we did end up losing.
Burn away, doubt.
Blessed by snow and stars.
Yuck. That was the worst possible card for us to see. That was a great hush. Yuck.
Still see far and clear.
Because we're gonna have something that's gonna be buffed up pretty good. You know, like we just played one spell last turn, so we're gonna have something with a +3.
We'll follow you to the edge of daybreak.
Okay, so something's gonna be +6, so we're going to go ahead and Fey Guide that thing that's the +6. Alright, looks like it's an Avarizen Sentry.
We will not suffer unbelievers.
They will not escape punishment.
Punishment. Wow. What a perfect sunburst. That was a perfect touch, now perfect sunburst. It kills this, I can't do anything about it, and it also silences it, I don't even get to draw a card. It's just perfect.
Devotion to battle.
Piercing rays. Ready the torches.
Just perfect.
Light the signal fires.
I don't even know if Nopify does anything.
Do not fear the shrouded path.
Well, if I would have played Troll Chant last turn, this Zed would be a 6-5 instead of a 3-2.
Daylight warms the heart and lights the way. Keep your head down, okay?
So I could potentially have Field of Rush next turn.
Into darkness.
These sunbursts are so clutch. Oh, thanks, Denai. Would have been nice to have you the last two turns. Okay, so that was created by Robin. That's what I thought. I'm gonna just let that happen because I want to play Field of Rush. Oh, there, a Deny deck too. Well, I guess nothing can go right. Yeah, I should have just notified that Zenith Blade. Got too greedy with the Field of Rush, I guess. Nothing worked out this game.
I'm not afraid.
This would be a good winter.
Yeah, not a very big Lee. Only just a regularly sized Lee. I'll just wait till next turn, because if I play it right now, I don't have Deny. Yeah, Man, this is a difficult deck to play. But yeah, everything went really, really well for my opponent. Because I need to keep spells in my hand for Lee Sin. And so I didn't want to play both Troll Chant and Flash Freeze. Okay, going back to try the go-hard matchup again. I like our opening hand. The Harsh Winds, not a card that I necessarily need. Obviously, I don't play anything here because I need to Nopify a go-hard. So I'll have Nopify, and I'll have Elixir of Iron. Obviously we want like the Zed to do Nexus damage to them, but killing Powder Keg is necessary, of course.
Where do you stand on cold shots?
Alright, so one go hard has been countered. Alright, Two Gohards have encountered. Let's draw a Nullify or another Deny. All right, cool. It burned a Gangplank due to the Pool Shark. That's good. Well, I don't have Deny for that anymore, but at least they're down to just one Gohard left in their deck.
You can see the Devastian border from here.
Yeah, I saw the Zoe reveal. Looked really cool. Oh, we're playing the Dreadway version again. I was really hoping with that salvage that we were going to see a Gohard there and they would have burned the other one. They would have tossed the other one. That would have been fantastic.
I can endure the dragon's fury.
Suppose you want in on this.
I suppose I should leave you be.
Conflict is all in the mind. I'll see this through. Strike first. Prepare yourself.
Just go normal.
Try again.
Neither the flames nor the deaths could claim me. Captain.
Where do you stand on cold shots?
This is going to be a close game. Gangplank's Parley. Why would they not play that first and then play the Pool Shark in the free slot? So they just got rid of something could have had for free.
Never lost a fair game. Never played one.
So levels up Gangplank.
I will not hold back.
What I'm thinking about the Will of I the problem with the Will of Ionia, if I play it right now, then I just get barriered. Like my barrier gets destroyed by the red card.
Who says I don't share?
But if I wait, now I can't play Zed for another blocker and also Will of Ionia. I can't do both of those. Maybe I go Zed. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Harsh Winds. No, I think I just bounce this.
I'll see this through.
Got a surprise for him.
Look out for reefs! Light the signal fires!
Without a sound.
These old eyes still see far clear. 9 mana?
Conflict is all in the mind. I will not hold back.
This is going to be close. So that's 6 out of 8.
Conflict is all in the mind. My lands need.
I guess I should have frostbitten one of those things.
Center your spirit.
Yeah, I should have frostbitten one of those things.
Dragon spirit awakens.
Of course, I just want to level up Lee Sin.
Strike first. Prepare yourself.
We go as one.
Okay, there. I was like, is this not going to do the Dragon's Rage? Gonna be another super close game. a fake heart is so good. Okay, well,
I'm a people person.
We're at six.
Alert the village.
So 10 mana next turn. So if I play Starlet Seer, then I have Harsh Winds and Deny. If I don't play it, I can have Harsh Winds, Deny, and Troll Chant. I think I want Harsh Winds, Deny, and Troll Chant, but I guess you would really want to play this first. No, I gotta have Troll Chant.
Explosive.
They're gonna have an attack. Be able to deal two on attack.
Watch this.
Blow him to the depths.
I will not hold back. Act free of doubt. Their heartbeat is quickened. Conflict is all in the mind.
Quick death was
okay.
Good.
That went well. In case of, you know, ruination, we have that.
For silver I talk, for gold I listen.
Okay, there's the last Gohard. So they are out of Gohards in their entire deck. I'm down to two.
Who goes there?
Feral.
I'll see this through.
This would be a good winter.
Center your spirit.
Many faces.
So this isn't going to kill them because they're going to block both of these. This will put them down to three, but I'll be able to heal my Nexus quite a bit. Alright, deny that.
Conflict is all in the mind.
Okay. We cleared the board. Lee Sin's still alive. That's two Vengeance. They're out of Gohard. They've played two Vengeance. They burned one Withering Wail. I saw that. They also burned the 9-mana card. Yuck. Does one damage.
Something for all.
Wonder why they chose red card there. That could be crazy. I feel like that was like a, you know, should have been like a blue card.
I rarely forget and never forgive.
All right, let's get some 10-10s. Feel the rush. Man, these games that we've played, all four of them, so close. The third one was the one that was the least close, but still.
The enemy
it's kind of crazy how we're 0-3, but we're like really close to 3-0. It's just these games have been really cool. All right, there we go. Got that one 1-3 now.
I thank you, dragon.
The Lee Sin healed us twice is because it did the Dragon's Rage kick. So it kicked the opponent's unit and it kicked the opponent's Nexus. So it kicked twice, and so that's why it healed for 8 instead of healing for 4, even though it had 4 power. All right, I'll keep the counter spells against the Ezreal Vi deck. I don't want to see their champions early because I don't play removal. So don't want to see. I want them just to have a handful of removal spells that we get to kind of counter. All right, Fey Guide can give something elusive that can block Ezreal. Also, they could just not have Ezreal. That would be nice. They'll lead with the Sentry, so I don't really care if that thing dies. But then next turn, we'll have 4 mana, so I can play Starlight Seer with Nopify back up. Oh, they're a go-hard deck. Right, Shadow Isles, go-hard. Okay, I should have... Should not have done that. I should have just passed and... Starlight Seer next turn.
Who goes there?
These eyes see all.
Their deck doesn't draw nearly as many cards as the Bilgewater version of Go Hard, though, so that it's much more difficult for them to have pack your bags. Normally. Or they could just start with all three of them in their opening hand, I guess. Three mana left over after Fae Guide. Yeah. I don't think I need to deny this turn.
Here comes the punchline.
And obviously I'll trade Fae Guide for Vi if they want. That Will of Ionia is nice. I can reset Vi. Nah, I let that happen. Stygian Onlooker. So I have to bounce Vi during their attack. Otherwise, I just bounce it, they replay it. The third go hard? How are they drawing so many of these? I really don't want to deny that.
Blessed by snow and stars.
Alright, now I can bounce this. Because they can't replay it. Basically, this deck I kind of want to keep deny for Ruination, Vengeance, that kind of stuff. Resets the Vi.
Let them see me, not you.
I'll wait till next turn to play this Lee Sin. Alright, I'll have them waste all their mana. Sounds good.
Don't blink, or you'll miss me.
Now I could have denied a go hard.
I feel pretty confident about being able to deny.
Kind of anything now. I hope that's Vengeance.
Yeah, we can deny all the stuff.
So Ezreal is at 5 out of 6. Let's not let them draw. And level up Ezreal at the same time. Denied. So next turn, I'm going to have 11 mana, so I'll have Lee Sin with 1 deny. Or I could play the Howling Abyss.
Beware the dragon spirit.
Nah. Well, Lee Sin. They don't have very many cards left. All right, they will sacrifice their Ezreal to draw two.
I will not hold back.
I'm at seven. So let's level up Lee Sin.
Conflict is all in the mind. As the dragon
so this
wins.
Is going to be 11, 14, 14 damage to them.
I'll go first.
Prepare yourself.
And the next turn I have 11 mana, which is perfect for Howling Abyss plus Deny. So like Howling Abyss is great against Ruination, but obviously I still have Deny anyway. Definitely possible this Howling Abyss should just be another Fielder Rush. You know, like that's, I just wanted to play, we talked about that at the beginning. I just kind of wanted to play a Howling Abyss, but.
They will learn to fear the sump.
Nah. Yeah, my opponent's like every card I play, my opponent's like, I am more and more dead. Alright, there we go. GG's.
I thank you, Dragon.
So pretty awesome deck here, honestly. Felt really good about this one with that 2 and 3. Especially those first two losses. Very, very good, interesting games back and forth and everything, and I just, you know, barely lost, but, you know, maybe I could have barely won them. So, really interesting deck. Lee Sin Zed. So, you know, if you're a Lee Sin Zed player, kind of tired of the Targon version, try this Freljord version. I think this was a lot of fun to play. You know, Fielder Rush was good. Again, maybe this should just be two Fielder Rushes. I was a little underwhelmed by the Fey Guide. I thought like the Fey Guide was going to be better than it was. I think these two slots you could maybe play. You know, you could play something else. You definitely want a unit. I just don't know what unit is the best. What do you want? What do you want to play? Maybe Kindly Tavern Keeper. Maybe that's what we should have here. Is a nice Kindly Tavern Keeper. I could see that. I could see Kindly Tavern Keeper being the thing to play. You'll play like Hearthguard, Jewel Protector. You need some kind of other unit to kind of have earlier. Avarozen Trapper is an option. I don't love Avarozen Trapper in this kind of deck though. But that's definitely an option. Deny was just incredible, right? Like that's kind of like the reason to play these kind of decks is Deny is so good these days. Could just be Eye of the Dragon. Maybe Fey Guide should be Eye of the Dragon. I guess we see the other Lee Sin Zed decks play Eye of the Dragons and they do some good work. So it's something like that. I do like Kindly Tavern Keeper these days, how it can block Fearsomes. And, you know, maybe healing stuff's good. But yeah, I think I would get rid of the Fey Guides and either Tavern Keeper or Eye of the Dragon. Probably Eye of the Dragon. Because I'm thinking against Gohard, I think you'd rather have Eye of the Dragon than the Tavern Keeper. But against Fearsome, you'd rather have the Tavern Keeper, for sure. Eye of the Dragon's not really doing anything against Fearsome. So I'm not sure if you have a preference. You could go the Coward's Way out and just split the difference and play one of each. If you can't decide which one you want. But we saw like our Lee Sin be damaged. Multiple times, and of course Starlet Seer makes some larger things so they can be damaged so the Tavern Keeper can heal them besides healing our Nexus. The Spirit's Refuge was pretty clutch though, a couple of times healing the Nexus. That was clutch. So there we go. Maybe just play an Eye of the Dragon and a Tavern Keeper, and then if you know, if you want like the power Fielder Rush, go with those. If you want like the coolness of Howling Abyss, go with that. You know, do what you want there. Two Fielder Rush probably makes a better deck, but Howling Abyss is too cool. All right, so that's Lee Sin Zed. Those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there. And of course, feel free to leave those comments. Let me know what you think of the deck and these games and everything like that. Hope you enjoyed this one, even with us going, getting off to the rocky start. Hopefully y'all still enjoyed it. But anyway, that's it here for Lee Sin Zed. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.